शिफ्ट की let us first talk about this coherent UPS case. That means we have two bits grouped together, so we have four different combinations. And if you remember in the last class, we are discussing these things. With that means I have this term, that is root e of cos 2i minus 1 pi by 4. That means this is your that root 2 by t is here. So I have root e cos of 2i minus 1 into pi by 4. So this is my SI one, and similarly this is SI one, and SI two, that is equal to minus of root e sine of y minus 1 to pi. Now, and what we have done, you see that our basic, in our phasor diagram, what did we do? Just keep it. In our phasor diagram, so generally we have drawn the phasor with respect to cosine function. That is, what is my reference phase for cosine? The reference phase is this. I think you can remember, because that first, if you can see, if you can remember, that means that cosine is basically it started like this. So if you try plot the phasor, actually what I am always assuming that phasor moves in an anticlockwise direction, and so this is my 0 degree, this is my pi by 2, okay, because my reference phase is this direction. When it is sine, then actually it matches with the general physical angle. When we do it with cos, electrical angle is 90 degrees phase shifted with the mechanical. Okay, so in this way we, because this is, and please remember, this is the phase lead. This is phase lead. Okay, this is a phase lead with, generally we talked about sine theta and phase lag, but here it is phase lead. So if it is, that means that, and if you, the book has not given clearly, that is, this is equal to I equal to 1, 2, 3, and 4. I equal to 1 means most probably pi by 4. I equal to 1 means it is pi by 4, but pi by 4 from where? Pi by 4 from the reference space. Pi by 4 from the reference phase means, so pi by 4 from the So this is your 0 degree. So that means 5 by 4 is here. That means it is your 10 point. Then 0, 0 is 5 by 3 pi by 4. I just check it, because I equal to 2, that is 4, 3 pi by 4. 3 pi by 4 means 12, that is, it is 0, 0. And then it is equal to 3, that means it is 0, 1. If it is, then it is 1. And basically what you are doing, basically you are transmitting for this SIT, basically T is between 0 to capital T, and depending on this phase information, you are passing this, you are sending that carrier, you are modulating the carrier, and basically you are modulating the, YPS, you are modulating the phase of the carrier. This is the carrier. Okay, so that's why FCT. Actually, it should be capital FC because it is in some gigahertz. Okay. Now that, so 1110001. So that. Pi by 4, pi by 4, pi by 4, they have given the, actually it is the phase of QPSK signal, that is pi by 4 lead, pi by 4. They have given it a different. But anyway, it doesn't matter. That means the phase of QPSK signal, that means it is, if I just take I equal to 1, what will happen? Cos pi by 4. So if it is 1, 0, it is cos pi by 4, no, minus sin pi. Minus sign by like 4 means it is, that means root 2 and minus 2. So if it is I equal to 1, then I equal to 1 means, that is, your SI will be basically SI equal to, say, SI 1. So if it is, at least for I equal to S, rather if I take S 1, then basically cos pi by 4 means 2t minus 2t. S 2 basically cost of 3 pi by 4 means how much? Cost 3 pi by 4? What is cost 3 pi by 4?
Minus 1.
1 by root.
minus root e by 2 and sin theta by 4. Okay. So similarly, I have S3 and S4. So root e by 2. Oh, they have turned it in root e by 2 minus root e by 2. Then minus root e by 2 sine, what about minus sine 3 pi by 4? This is minus, what about S3? Cos 5 pi by 4, cos 5 pi is minus root e by 2 and minus sine 5 pi by 4. It is minus root e by 2. What? I equal to 3 sine 5 pi by 4 means how much?
Minus 1 by root 2.
Then it will be plus. Because I have SI2 here, there's a minus. Okay. So this is my S3. And similarly, I have my S4 is 7 pi by 4 means cos 7 pi by 4 plus root e by 2
1 by 2
and then sine 7 minus of 7 sine 7 pi by 4 is minus of root e by 2. Okay. So that they have done and they have plotted this basically. So that means so this is your S4, S3, S2, S1. So if I just see that is root e by 2 minus root e by 2. Sorry. Root e by 2 minus root e by 2. That means root e by 2 minus root e by 2. This is actually they have that this picture is little this thing that actually ideally it should be this. They have this code actually they try to do the symmetry. That means see 1, 0. You see that as there's a negative 1, that's why that although it is pi by 4, pi by 4 means here with respect to pi by 2, that's why it is plus root e by 2. This is this one is actually this can be this mapping can be done in a better way because they sometimes what we do. Instead of here my plus, we put a minus and do the whole analysis. But anyway, so Heikin has done it in a way. So that means that 1, 0 means you know root e by 2 minus root e by 2. Root e by 2 minus this is root e by 2. Means they have done this plot is with respect to these two columns. This plot, this one, they have done it with these two columns. So 1, 0 means pi by 4. It's quite confusing. 0, 0 is 3 pi by 4. But phase is with respect to cos theta. Ideally they should have done that. This is your 1, 0. So if I just do it, let's see. This is your 1, 0. This is your 0, 0. Your 0, 0. And this is your 0, 1. Let's see what will happen. And then the fourth is 1. So if I do this, what will happen? Now let's see 1, 0. That means root e by 2 minus root e by 2. Root e by 2. X is root e by 2. Y is minus root e. So it's also not coming in there. 2 is to 0. Previous rule. So what they have done, that they have calculated this SI1 and SI2 means, but actually what generally people do they is Phi1 and Phi2. Generally in our electrical engineering we do it in a completely different way, so that it is matched actually. So that if it is Phi by 4, it should be plus 2T by 2 plus 2T by 2 Chi Phi by 4. It should be some kind of plus 2t by 2 minus 2t by 2. I mean, minus 2t by 2 plus 2t by 2 that. But anyway, so the basic point is that you have four constellations and four this diagram. Okay. So that they have done that 2t, 2 minus 1 and 2t, that's a minus. Okay. So these we have started. And one thing to see is that the basic point, what I like to say, means, see, this constellation, even if you change it in a different way, it doesn't matter actually. Because if you put something, sometimes people can do something like that. 0, 0 is 5 by 4, quite, which make the life simple. 0, 1 is 3 pi by 4. 1, 0 is 5 pi by 4. And 1, 1 is 7 pi. You can choose the constellation in that way also. And for that, when you are saying 0, 0, pi by 4, you are taking something root e by 2, this SI1 and SI2, you are taking root e by 2, root e by 2. So that is positive one. Then 0, 1, 3 pi by 4, that is minus, this is plus. Then 5 pi by 4, that is both are minus, that means that root e by 2, root e by 2. And for 1, they sometimes we do it in that way. Okay. So, in that case, most probably a bit different way, most probably. They are 90 degree phase shifted one. Little phase shift, if you do it, it will come. But anyway, they have done it in a bit different way. So the point is not that which one you will choose, the point is that if you choose in this way, your phase of the QPSK signal and the coordinates of the message points. That is like this. So, but anyway, check it that if there is similar design. Now you see the basic point is that here you see that means when I have if I have a transition from here to here, means either 1, 0 to 1, 0, 1 or 0, 1 to 1, 0. Then what will happen? Your phase shift will be pi by 4 to 5 pi by 4. That means almost phase shift is pi, means plus minus pi. Similarly, if I have a constellation from here to 0, 0 to 1, 1 or 1, 1 to 0, 0, then also this phase shift is plus minus pi. Now phase shift in plus minus pi means in a sinusoid, that means say I have a, I'm just drawing you the, what is the problem of the phase shift of pi. Say I have a up to t, say I have a signal like that. This is my t, t means one big deviation. Okay, rather I'm taking it, big deviation, then that will be clear. I will compute with time period. So this is my big duration. So I am sending one carrier like this. Okay. Now the next one, if I have a phase shift of pi, say say I have say 0 0, that's why I have transmitted this one. Say I have now I have the name I have 1 0. That means I told that I have a phase shift and say pi by 4. I'm just taking it pi by 4. Sine pi by 4 means I'm taking from say this. It doesn't matter where from it start. What I like to say. Even if I do that analysis, that means if I just shift it to pi by 4, that means it will start from little delayed one. Okay. So now after that 1 0 means I have what is 1 0? 1 0 is basically opposite. Okay. Because say if it is pi by 4, or rather I am saying that 0 phase shift, and then it is pi phase shift. Okay. Then and because now when you are doing a pi phase shift, so what will happen with the pi phase shift? So that means initially your phasor was here, now your phasor was here. So that means you see it started that side, now it started this side. So that means it is going to be negative. Now with sinusoid, I don't have that this type of problem. Now you see for cosine, what is the problem? Why people take cosine and do the analysis? Because cosine has certain other requirement. So now what happened, that say I have transmitted this. Okay, this is my say 0 0. Now when I am doing a 1 0, say it is a some sort of a 180 degree phase shift. 0 0 to something. Say this is your 0 0, and then you are transmitting 1 1. Then if it is a 180 degree phase shift, then what will happen from here to again? You have to start it like this. That's a huge jump, and this huge jump is leaving because you are transmitting it in a electrical system. That means huge jump is always problematic. You are flash over this. So what we want, and also when you do this thing in electrical system, there's a harmony because we don't want this type of discontinuity. Okay. So what we have then, what we have to do, say, so can we reduce this discontinuity? Can you reduce this discontinuity? Okay. Now in this reducing the discontinuity, what we do, that is offset quadrature phase shift. Okay. And you see that you say here it is what we have done, 0 1, then 1 0. 0 1 1 0, let's see. That means 0 1, then 1 0. See if there's a pi shift. I'm explaining you where is the pi shift. For 0 1, see the phase in phase component is like this. And for 1 0, and it is a 180 degree phase, but this is the in phase component from. You see that depending on that SI1, for you see for 0 1, what is my SI1? For 0 1, it is minus 2T by 2 and plus 2T by 2. That means I have multiplied in this component with minus 2T by 2 cosine of that one, and SI2 was 0 1 plus root by 2 plus root by 2 sine theta. So this one plus in multiplying it plus root e by 2 sine. That is that plus 1 minus 1 that. So, and but here you see that here for 1 0, what is my 1 0? 1 0 is basically plus root e by 2 minus root e by 2. Here I am multiplying with plus root e by 2 and this is minus root e by 2. Okay. Now you see that in this one plus root e by 2 cos at minus root e by 2 sine, that's why it is coming negative. Okay. Now you see that means at this position when you are adding up, when you are adding up, you see that at this position you have a phase change of pi that we are talking about. That we are talking about. This is the phase change of pi. Because from 0 versus that we have seen that here also that we can see that there's a means because the if you add it up, because as this is 0, so I have the this is the amount of phase change is pi. The amount of phase change is pi. That this much discontinuity we want to remove it here. Because this is the value is the amplitude of the signal. Now what we have to do, what that in this offset QPR, what we do that this offset QPS scale, that in a normal QPS means normal QPS scale, what we do for NPS. That means what are my this thing? This is your 1 0. This is 0 0. This is 0 1, and this is 1 1. And it can say this point can go to next. This point go to that. That means from 1 0 then 1 1 because randomly it is coming. So from any point it can go to other 3 points. Okay. Now in offset and when we go to other, that is from 1 0 to 0 1, when we move, then there's a 180 degree phase shift. Similarly, from 0 0 to 1 1, then there's also 180 degree phase shift. This is the basic problem. Now, what we can do in this offset QPSK, we are rather restricting that this one and this one, these two transition cannot be done. You can do this, yes. You cannot do means think. Bit stream must come into like that. Your bit stream may come 1 0 to 0 1. But you will see that even if I do that, my phase transition will not be 180 degree. Rather, when there is a phase transition 180 degree, that is 1 0 to 0 1 or 0 0 to 1 1, you will see my phase transition instead of pi, my phase transition will be pi by 2. And when I have a phase transition of pi by 2, suddenly I have certain advantages. I have less amount of this. So, what I am doing here, that means here I have a standard for one. It is the same, that means I have a basis function for in phase. That means that is the same thing, root 2 by t cos 2 pi fct 0 to t. But what I am doing, I am making a delay in the quadrature area, basically. Okay. What I am doing, I am a delay. That means generating a quadrature component is delayed or offset. That's why that one, you see that instead of 0 to t, I am doing a t by 2 to 3 t by 2. Now you see that means what basically I am doing over here. Now you see that if I have, let me take up this one. Say I am transmitting 1 0 0. Because in the previous test we have seen 1 0 to 0 1. That means when if I do 1 0 to 0 1, what will happen? That means 1 0 to 0 1, there's a 180 degree shift. Now let us do in this offset one. That means what is the advantage that I am getting? Only thing is that I have this. My shift is quadrature component is delayed. Now for 1 0. If you remember that 1 0 means I have root e by 2 cos pi t. 1 0 2 means 1, 0 means that I have 1 kilo means root, both are positive. Okay. So, what I am doing that 1 0 means 2t by 2 and and 0 means root t by 2 and minus root t by 2. And what is my for 1 0 the quadrature component? Quadrature component is that for this one and also okay. So for 0 1 what is that case? For 0 1 what is my SI one? 01, what is the SI? For 01, let us see. For 01 also, it is minus root by 2. Okay. Minus root by 2 means if I just plot, it will be something like that. So, this is a cosine channel, that means I channel. Now let us do the Q channel. But for Q channel, for 1 0, we have seen that it is a delayed because it is a, this is your. Generate that area. And for 1 0, what is the case? What is that one? Minus root by 2. That means I will generate minus root by 2. That means I will generate minus root by 2 sine 2 by c. And how much? From t by 2 to c t by 2. So what I am doing? I am just generating the c and t. Now, if I do this thing, now you see that now let us, we have to check at this point what is the phase change. Now see, before this zone, let us, now you have to check, now you have to do the analysis between each t by 2 interval. So in this one, what was the phase? If I just draw the, you can remember that circle one. That means it was coming, so, and it is like this, okay, and it is moving in an anti-clockwise direction. And what is my phase over here in this side? It is the phase, okay. Now, just after this, what is my phase? This is going. The same one. What is the phase? Going up. Okay. Now what is the phase over here? Total, if I just, you have to add it up, because this is I channel and this is Q channel. The resultant phase is like this, and this, it is something like this. I by 4, that side by 1. And what about this? This side phase is here. So now what is the phase delay? The phase change at this junction, it is pi by 2. Because it had moved from here to here at this 2. If you just add it up, if you add it up these 2, that actually you have a phase change. But if you remember in the previous case, my offset, normal QPSK, my phase change was pi. But now my phase change is pi by 2. If there's a phase change of pi by 2, if you can, which I have shown in for phase change, what is the maximum this thing from here to pi phase change means it will go to 2 unit. But if I have a phase change of pi, then pi by 2, then it will be 1 unit. So that's why that this is the offset UPSK means. Here, that quadrature carrier, you are giving an offset of T by 2. Okay. Now, but in the previous case, we have seen from the table that there is a phase shift of pi. Now, so that means that in our, so similarly, you can, I have shown it 10 and 01 case, 1001. And similarly, you can fast, you can do on your own, say fast 0, then 10, and do the same plot. Then you can do 1001, also 001. You can also plot 0011 and also 110. Okay. And what you have to do for 01, there's a there are two things. There's been tired. If you plot the carrier, that is for 01, it is 0 capital T, then 10 something. Okay. And you have to, and always you remember in this case, always there's a, now the one thing, that means yes, you have got this you have now less that there is you are restricting your the constellation point. That means it cannot move here to here or here to here, it can only move to in that. Only this. You are restricting this crisscross movement. But what is the disadvantage? That if now earlier what happened, that if you remember that in your picture, that what you have got earlier, you got this type of sharp change. You see that earlier you may get this type of sharp change means after T amount of time, after the symbol time. Okay, see. That is, you may change because there, if there's a 1010 duplicate symbol, then there will not be any change. You see that there is no phase change over here. But if there's a 1000, again you have a phase change. So, but basic point is that means even if you may have phase change, you may not have phase change, but phase change after T amount of time, you will get the phase change. But here you see that is as that this one, this quadrature carrier is shifted by T by 2. Now you see that here also, that previous this side also different carrier. Okay, I mean different shifted carrier. So now that you see that your phase shifting, you will get more frequently. That means your phase shifting will be, you may get phase shift, may not get phase. If it is there's a duplicate, you will not get the phase shift because your constellation, if it is duplicate, means what? You are getting, you are here, next symbol also you are here. So there is no phase shift. But the point is that now, that is this shifting is more frequent because T by 1, because here one phase shift, similar that here also you will get another phase shift. Why? Because you have done this 10. Earlier you have got the fish, I explained it here, but earlier there is no fish shift, so you have anyway here it is 0. But there may be some other thing, that means if you choose some other symbol, this will not be 0, this will be something else, so that there will be a, if you just add it up, there will be a discontinuity. So if you just do these things, you will see that now earlier that when you have your constellation like this, means all can, anybody can go anywhere. Then your this one was T, means after T duration you get this change, but now you are getting after T by. So this is, and that another thing is that if you check that constellation, that means that you see that the message point, that you say this is your 1 0 1 1 0 1 0 0. If you can remember that it is all root T by 2, this is your root T by 2, this is my, so that means if I means this one is how much? Because this is root T by 2, this is root T. That means this one is 2 root T. The diagonal is 2 root T. But any other thing, if these two diagonals are basically 2 root T jump, but this one is root 2. But if I have this or this, then I have root 2. The distance. Now, the thing is that now next we will do about that pi by 4 shifted QPS. Pi by 4 shifted QPS can mean that it is, and yes, another important thing is that means if you can check that instead of this cosine, this is your function. Now, instead of that, if I do something like that, and I carry here, I am taking just 1 minute. Now, instead of this phase, that means that 2i minus 1. Now, instead of that, if I would have done, that means in this phase 2i pi by 4. Okay. Then what will be my constellation diagram? My constellation will be, instead of, that means I have pi by 4, 2 pi by 4, means pi by 4, 3 pi by 4, 5 pi by 4, 7 pi by 4. Now in this case I have I equal to 1, I equal to say, and if I choose I something like that, I equal to 0, 1, 2, 3. That means I have I equal to 0. My constellation will be, so I just plot this one. So either people choose, and in this case that either people choose this type of constellation or people choose this type of constellation. Either of these. Okay. So now you see that means what I like to say, that either I will do this type of constellation, that means that 2i pi by 4, that is I equal to 0, that is I this one. This one, and it can move, anybody can move anywhere. So you see that okay. And this one we have started, that a normal, so either of these versions of QPSK people can use. Now in this pi by 4 shifted QPSK, pi by 4 shifted QPSK, please remember this is all coherent PSK. Okay, coherent modulation, demodulation, coherent bandpass modulation, demodulation, because carrier information is required, that's it. Phase information is required. If it is non-coherent, then the phase information is not required at the receiver side. Now what we do that now we are sending the modulated carrier alternatively from this constellation and that constellation. Okay. Now, that means, if you can remember that what was my distance? What was my distance over here? that plus root t by 2. You can remember that this distance was root t by 2. And but what about this distance? Like if I do this thing, that means if it is pi by 4, then actually I have a, this one was, this distance was root e by 2, if you can remember. Because that pi by 4 means 1 by root 2 terms are coming. But if I choose that, this one, okay, that means when I equal to 0, then 0, when I equal to 1, pi by 2. So that means this one was basically root e. So now you see that so this one is at root e, but this one is at root e by 2. And what I am doing, I am alternatively transmitting the, I am alternately peaked. That means the carrier phase used for transmission of successive symbols is alternatively picked from one of the two QPSK conformations. That means, say I am just giving an example. Say I have, this is my constellation 00, 01, 10, 1. And say my constellation is here also. Now what I am doing, say if I have a, now I have a transmission. Something 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. Okay. Now I am doing that 0, 0 means I will transmit first this one, this carrier. Then next 0, 0, I will transmit this one, okay? Then I will transmit 0, 1. 0, 1 means I will transmit this one, okay? And then 1, 0, means again I will transmit this one. So then what will happen, that means these two constellations, that, so that means it can, so if I just superimpose these two, that means what is that? So this is my one constellation, my one QPSK one, that previous one what we discussed, and another one is that this, if I just plot it, then this, and this. Okay. Now what will happen, you see that it can, this from red, I can go to this blue. So it has been arrowed. Just from this red to this red, I can. Similarly, say from this blue, I can go to this red. Now see, that means in this case, you will see that you have, means further, you will see this switching. That means the phase transition from means plus minus pi by 4 or plus minus 3 pi by 4. That means that if I, see, try to understand. It means I have, say this one, sorry. I have this one. Okay. I can go this one or this one or this one or this one. So either it is a 5/4, 5 minus 5/4, or it is 3/4 minus 3/4, plus minus 3. Similarly, it is from red also, you can do the same thing. So please, so this is the basic idea of the 5/4 shifted QPSK. Okay. So please, please and this can be differential QPSK. I'll try to explain that what is differential QPSK in the next class. So this is about different versions of QPSK. And there are MRE PSK means that you have the message points, and instead of one point, you have this is a rupee circle, and say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that means it is some sort of a 8 array system. Okay, that means what you have to do, that it is something like that 2 pi i/8. Okay. I0 means you are sending the 00 IPs. I01, that is 2 pi/8. It is 8 array means 3 bits together. 0, 0, 0, you are transmitting this carrier, that means 0 phase shift. Then this one, that means say you are, I'm just making my life simple, 0, 0, 1. Okay, this is your 0, 0, 0. This is your 0, 0, 1. That means I'm trying to make that I in the same way. Okay, that is I1, 2 pi/8, 5/4. This is your say 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. Okay. So then I equal to 2. That is I equal to 0, I equal to 1, I equal to 2. Similarly, I equal to 3. That means say it is 0, 1, 1. Then you can do 1, 0, 0. That is I equal to 4. Not necessarily you have to do this. And you can choose some other sequence. It doesn't matter actually. So this I make in order to make life simple. So similarly, I5, that means that 1, 0, 1, that means I5 means actually 5/8. That means 5 pi by 4. 5 pi by 4 means 5/4, 2 pi by 3 pi by 4 pi by 5. Yes. Similarly, this is your 6, that means what is that? 1, 1, 0. Then this is your 1, 1. Okay. You can choose the MRE PSK 23, it means 8 array in this way. And then you have 3 bits. Okay. Now, and what is my decision boundary? Decision boundaries will be always, that means, say this one and this one, I have to, because you see this is 5/4, this is 5/2. That means this will be 3 pi/4. Okay. So similarly, so there is equal distance, picture is a little different, okay. And this is your, so that means in this zone if something is there, so in this zone if something is there, so I have, yes, I know that this is a 001 is actually transmitted. Now that this MRE PSK, then now that, and this is quite important, that hybrid amplitude phase modulation. This is quite important. We generally talk about WAM. That means quadrature amplitude. That means I will modulate both phase, that's why it's quadrature, and I will modulate amplitude also. That means the phase modulation and amplitude modulation, both you are hybriding it. Okay. So, and here that phase is the same way, 5/1t and 5/2t. And what I am trying to do, you see that I have earlier what, that means here I have put this AK and BK. Okay. So this one, this by controlling this one, you can control certain things. That means WAMP means that basically earlier in the that MREPS, if you remember, that is I am not changing the amplitude. That means say in say PS, you see whether it will choose this constellation or the another constellation, that means this one, this one, this one. But basic this amplitude I am not changing. This amplitude, they are all constant. Well, this is root e by 2, but this is root e, whatever I choose. Okay. But in this one, what I am trying to do, I am not only changing the phase, that means, see, either I am transmitting this, also, see, this is your amplitude, amplitude you are changing. You are changing amplitude, though you are not changing the phase. Similarly, what you are doing, you are changing the phase, but not changing the amplitude. That means, say from blue to, say, you go to here, then you are not changing the amplitude, but you are changing. So that means both amplitude and phase you are changing in the of the area. That means amplitude you are changing and phase you are changing. That means this depending on this A case and B case and their CCS means their symbol, their signs. Okay. So generally this is called 16 square. This is there are four. This is generally called 16 square. That means there's a 16 constellation points, higher amplitude and phase. And in that way, I am the handling. That means amplitude is what? Amplitude only. That means d by 2, 3 d by 2. You will see this one. M16. That means the signal space diagram corresponding 4 times. This is my. That means d by 2, 3 d by 2, minus d by 2, minus 3 d by 2. So, always you see the same thing. That means the amplitude portion is d by 2, 3 d by 2, minus d by 2, minus 3. Phase, you will notice that phase is that. Is how many different phase? Yes. This phase is first 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 1. So similarly the opposite. So this is the case. Okay, so tomorrow again we will discuss. Thank you. Okay, just one moment. Don't. So when did I announce the test? What is the date of test? Hello?
Sir, 26th.
26. Okay, so thank you.